driving back out to hang out with my brother.
To here?
How would you describe yourself?
Metal fusion.
Fusion metal. Or metal fusion, depending on your preference.
If there was someone that I knew didn't listen to a lot of the bands that I listen to, I'd say, you know, it's kind of like Foo Fighters, kind of like Weezer, kind of like maybe Sunny Day Real Estate, if I had to really stretch it.
It's more of like kind of like an experimental metal jazz.
Progressive metal.
Yeah.
We're just a rock band. Started then, we're friends.
This is the way it worked. I've known Jim since preschool.
I grew up in Mesa.
I think I've known him for like 20 years or something like that.
My mom and his mom are friends.
My dad played guitar too, so.
I'm Jack. I'm the old man.
You knew Tom. Yeah, since 7th grade, junior high.
Yeah.
And so what happened, the whole link was that I met Tom like early in high school.
We were seniors in high school. Just hang out in his garage.
I played with Tom in a band and I would play with Jim every once in a while. So it's like, we ended up all playing together and then Rick ended up in the band, and then that was it.
Our first show was at Name Brand Exchange.
Yeah, it's pretty much like an upscale thrift store for like high school, you know, girls.
We would just take pretty much any show that we could get.
What are some of the bands that most influenced you guys?
Mostly Destiny's Child.
Luke, you're not getting a serious answer.
That's what they say,
though. Like Velvet Underground, Wedding Present, Jesus, Mary Chain.
Second and third grade, I got into like Quiet Riot. Then it branched out to like Violent Femmes and like Dead Milkmen.
Rocket from the Crypt, I don't know.
I liked Metallica a lot. I was never really dominated by anything, any one particular thing.
Fugazi is like hands down, easily top three.
Tom drives into the club tonight, right? He has stands up.
That's the dumb question.
And he's blaring Methods of Mayhem with the sunroof, like kind of going like this back and forth.
Actually, you know what I was blaring for real, like when I drove up, is Def Leppard Pyromania.
Yeah.
Awesome, dude. Like that record changed my life pretty much when it came out.
There's so many different top tens, you know, like top tens for right now, or like, you know, top 10 before 1990, or top 10, you know, like this year or whatever. There's so many. It's hard.
It's how the hustle goes. See what the jukebox knows.
We had no label, no management, and the only help we had was Mark Trevino, like producer, engineer.
We all believe he's probably one of the best people out there making records. It's called Bleed American. The first single is called Bleed American.
I thought that cool thing about it was that we didn't really have any like label people coming in, you know? It was just like we were, you know, just us and Mark. But we didn't have like, you know, there was really no pressure.
There was no pressure, but there was all the pressure.
I felt a lot. I felt more pressure making this record than Clarity. Because
me
it was
too,
like
me too.
I felt that this record was something we could like have something to prove.
Dude, it was out of our own pocket.
Yeah, that's more pressure, dude.
There's no
what are you talking about?
The blame onto. It's all you.
I was comfortable.
That's good.
I didn't.
There's a little bit more pressure to kind of deliver, which is a good motivation for us, I think, to work harder.
And we had a couple friends coming in, like giving advice, which was cool.
Clark lent us some equipment to record Bleed American. These guys probably were one of the first bands that I saw when I was a young kid.
Love you guys, dude.
guest appearances on the record?
Rachel Hayden, formerly playing in Bad Dog, and gals doing their own stuff.
Lord himself?
Jesus Christ, the Lord himself. Maybe Bumble from Promise Ring does backups and like lead, actually, I don't know, Kurt.
Doug Messenger does hand claps on the record.
Doug Messenger,
Travis Keller.
Van Morrison's guitarist at one point does hand claps.
Yeah.
We saved up money and we toured kind of like a fundraising tour.
We were paying for it, not a major label was paying for it. Like they cut us a deal on the rate. And the last check we cut for our mixing was like, man, I hope this doesn't bounce.
We went for the full on rock thing, you know.
Hey, don't write yourself off yet. It's only in your head you feel left out or looked down on. Just try your best. Try everything you what they tell themselves when you're away. It just takes some time. Little girl, you're in, a little out the ride. Everything, everything will be just fine. Everything, everything will be alright, alright. It just takes some time. Little girl, you're in, a little out the ride. Everything, everything will be just fine. Everything, everything will be alright.
Hey Bert, we're shooting.
Naked women.
Oh man, there's...
Oh, that was our way. That was the 80s, that's right.
The name comes from Jim's little brother. He drew up
Tom.
Tom.
I can't believe it. How many times have we told that story?
I pretty much just tell everyone to ask Tom. I just defer that to Tom.
Tom, hey, wait, no, sit down. Sit down, Tom.
How about your brother? All right. It's a drawing. It's a drawing that my brother drew.
Hey, your brother Tom kicks ass.
Like, 7 or 8 years ago.
It's a misconception that my name has something to do with it.
And I have a brother named Jim, who's kind of a bigger guy.
It's kind of unfortunate coincidence.
And I have a brother named Ed, and they got in a fight one time, and Jim went into his room, locked the door, and my brother Ed drew this picture. It said Jimmy Eat World.
Tom has been through a lot of band names, too.
And it was him eating the world, like saying that he was so fat that he could eat the world.
Pretty cool joke.
They're still fighting.
I don't know why we all thought it would be a good band name at the time. The whole idea of like band names is kind of funny. What's our band gonna be called? We hadn't had a song on the radio in about a year. Still, we would like sell out like pretty much everywhere we went.
When we toured, they were like, they came out and supported us in a big way, and they, you know, not only did they come and show up, but they bought CDs, they bought shirts.
This one we only have in large right here. And I believe it's cotton. It's Fruit of the Loom. It's a really popular brand.
Have you had weird, crazy fans?
Everyone was like just really into it. They're the music fans. It's cool.
It's pretty good.
You guys rock tonight.
Thank you so
much. It was really good. Thanks. Loved it.
Thanks.
It rocked. It was so good. Jimmy Eat World. Those are great.
They actually used to play 3 houses down from where I live.
Jimmy Eat World.
And it's great to see them doing well.
It was great.
Just to know what they sounded like when they sucked, and now they're great. So.
Awesome. Good.
Best show I've ever seen in my life.
Jimmy Eat World eats the world.
It was awesome.
Woo! Woo! I drove 12 hours to see these guys. It was worth it.
Yeah.
Germany. What happened in Germany?
we learned how to say Ich will mehr Stimme auf dem Monte bitte.
Okay, this is the funniest story. We were driving from northern Germany to the very south of Germany.
Rick is always the last one.
We're perpetually waiting for no matter what we do.
Went to a rest stop and
it's time to go, so I'm still eating.
Rick walks up with a full plate of food just as we're all done.
Our tour manager's just take it, man. Now get it to go box.
Take my plate out to the bus.
He was in the bus. He walked off, or I don't know, to return a plate.
I go take my plate back. I come back. I'm walking outside, you know.
But we all thought that Rick was in the bus, so we left.
We left Rick behind.
I started chasing after him.
Like, he saw the bus like leave, and he starts running.
No, no! He was running after the bus.
So like they just keep driving.
So he was sitting there for like 5 hours at this rest stop in Bavaria.
I looked at every magazine. I couldn't read. It's all in German. Ate some ice cream. It was good ice cream. Bavaria has really good ice cream.
He wasn't mad.
I was all okay. I was just laughing.
We keep making jokes like, Rick, dude, you gotta see the tape of you running after the bus, man. It's hilarious.
The whole time we've been a band, touring and hanging out and recording, I don't think we've ever gotten into an argument or fight. I like playing shows, going completely around the world. I hear a lot of good things about Australia, going to Japan, going to Europe, trying to go to new places. I'm afraid I'm not gonna want to come home. That should be better than hanging out in Arizona, I think. Arizona's great, but you need an escape plan for the summer, man. It's just too hot. We really want to make the show something where, like, if you didn't come, then you messed up.
I think maybe after our last record, which ends with this kind of like Tom playing like a flick club, we're trying to do an interview, like, never mind.
What's the rule, guys?
Passing.
No booty shots.
Okay.
Your DreamWorks debut, it's a pretty big deal in America.
Yeah, this is our first show ever, so we're kind of nervous, but I think it should be cool.
When DreamWorks came to us with the idea about starting a band,
uh-huh.
We were none of us knew how to play instruments.
Right.
It's been a busy 3 months, man. I had to learn how to play drums.
Uh-huh.
We're
okay.
Really
are
busy.
Are you guys going to be the next band that's going to be running around naked all over the place like Blink 182?
Yes.
No, DreamWorks is calling this one of their best albums of the year. If that's not a compliment, I don't know what is.
I have to agree with them.
You look like the kind of guy that keeps these guys in line. Am I right?
Yeah, someone has to.
Okay, can you guys select your name for the camera?
Yeah, my name's Rick. Rick Burge.
Zach Lind, Z-A-C-H-L-I-N-D.
Jim Adkins, A-D-K-I-N-S. Jim's just how it sounds.
Switchblade, S-W-I-T-C-H-B-L-A-D-E.
That's not your name.
It is. It's a stage name.
You get sick of having all those cameras pointed at you all the time.
It's strange.
I'm getting out. Now nothing ever shames me. I'm going out. I don't care if you're angry.
I'm having a good time. Makeup on my face.
See my movie.
Something, if there's like interesting ways where we can present the song, then it's it makes it even cooler.
We just kind of try to present the songs as unbiasedly as possible. It's rare that the songs are about any one particular event or thing. They're always kind of more what's been happening lately. It's always more like a journal entry. It could be describing like now, meaning like this week, you know, right now, or it could mean like lately, or it could be about, you know, just any sort of time frame.
What I was thinking to do encore, I was thinking play Hear You Me first.
I don't know, man. I was thinking coming out rocking.
There's no one in town I know. You gave us some place to go. I never said thank you for that. I thought I might get one more chance. What would you think of me now? So lucky, so strong, so proud. I never said thank you for that. Now I never have a chance. May angels lead you in. Hear you, me, my friends. On sleepless roads, the sleepless go. May angels lead you in.
When they do the behind the music on Jimmy World, and that moment when everything falls apart, what happens?
Oh, this is what's gonna happen right here.
He's got long hair. And
We're gonna get ready to go on tour. Tom's gonna fly to Hawaii to work out and get ready for the tour. On one of his runs where he holds a little weight.
That's from the journey. When I got from Journey.
No, no, this,
no, dude.
He's gonna go to Hawaii and then he's gonna fall down and hurt his hip or something like that.
That's
right?
The guy from Journey.
So he's gonna come back and say, man, I just can't do it. And then we're gonna say, you know what, Tom? We're gonna go out anyway. You know, and we're gonna call it Jimmy Eat World. We're not gonna, you know. Tom's gonna beg us, man, don't call it Jimmy Eat World.
As long as I get those royalty checks.